Thank you, everybody, for coming to the Aaron Torres Podcast YouTube page. I do have one quick favor before we get to the video that you came here for, and that is very simply this. You see that little red subscribe button below this video? Go ahead, smash that subscribe button. It really does help me. It really does help this channel grow and my audience grow. So go ahead and hit that red subscribe button. And now, here is the video that you came here for. All right, last little topic in college football, and let's go to what is basically the college football capital of the world right now, and that is Tuscaloosa. Not sure if you've heard, been a little bit of a busy week in Tuscaloosa for the Alabama Crimson Tide. They, of course, on Friday, New Year's Day, they go down to Dallas, play in the Rose Bowl that's really played at the Cotton Bowl, that's played at Jerry World, and they smoke Notre Dame. Don't blame Notre Dame. Notre Dame's a good program, but they're not on Alabama's level. By the way, on Tuesday, Devontae Smith is probably going to win the Heisman Trophy. But in the middle, some guy named Steve Sarkisian accepts the head coaching job with the Texas Longhorns. And so it puts Alabama kind of in this fascinating spot where they're getting ready to play for a national championship. But at the same time, Nick Saban is now looking or is in the process of looking for a new offensive coordinator. And there were some names bandied about early, but on Monday, we got the first official names of who could potentially be the offensive coordinator at Alabama. And how about this, people? You ready for a doozy? Because I got a doozy for you. Pro Football Talk gave two names that could potentially be the next offensive coordinators at Alabama. One, recently fired New York Jets football coach Adam Gase. Two, recently fired Houston Texans coach Bill O'Brien. And while I think Bill O'Brien would be potentially an interesting fit, former Penn State head coach, worked under Belichick, blah, 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 we need to talk about Adam Gase. Because Nick Saban, what are you doing, my man? And listen, look, first of all, let me say this. Nick Saban is a football savant. I mean, the guy is, I would argue, you know, him and Belichick, right? The two greatest football minds in the modern era of the sport. And one great thing that Nick Saban does, he not only has an incredibly keen eye for talent, but he's got a keen eye for coaches as well. Brings in smart, ambitious, creative people into his organization. You know, you just look at college football right now, right? Everywhere has his fingerprint on it. Jimbo Fisher at Texas A&M, Kirby Smart at Georgia, Lane Kiffin at Ole Miss, Steve Sarkisian, I just mentioned, is going to get the Texas job. On and on and on and on and on. And even, oh, by the way, how about somebody like Butch Jones getting another chance? Mike Locksley getting another chance? That is all because, not all because, but it is a huge part of what Nick Saban does. He has a great eye for young, up-and-coming coaches like Kirby Smart, like Will Muschamp many years ago, like Jimbo Fisher. But he also has this incredible ability to kind of find guys that have been kicked around a little bit, bring them in, bring him under his wing and do the Nick Saban thing, get him rehabbed, and get him on the way out the door. And this has worked really well, and I do give him a lot of credit, right? Like, Lane Kiffin was a national punching bag when he left USC. Fast forward, he's the offensive coordinator. Yeah, he's still goofy. There's a couple butt chewings on the sidelines, but he puts together some of the most productive offenses Alabama had ever had at the time. Basically gets them, by the way, to the playoff with Blake Sims as a quarterback, which is kind of incredible in its own right. Wins a national championship with Jacob Coker, which is incredible in its own right. And then ends up getting a head coaching job at Florida Atlantic, which leads to Ole Miss. And you can say what you want about Lane Kiffin, but it is clear that he rehabilitated his image. It's clear that he rehabilitated what he does, who he is, all that good stuff. Same with Steve Sarkisian, same with Butch Jones, same with some other guys. But I got to tell you, Adam Gase would be the project of the century for Nick Saban. Okay, remember Extreme Makeover Home Edition? This would be Extreme Makeover Coaching Edition, because Adam Gase, you got to be kidding me. And for starters, like, for people who don't really understand why or how there's a connection, first of all, like, on some surface level, I guess I get it, right? Adam Gase, for people who don't know, actually coached under Nick Saban at LSU, started as a graduate assistant, became an assistant coach under Nick Saban for about 3 or 4 years. Then he goes off to the NFL, where he's been for the last 15 years. I also understand it from Nick Saban's perspective. He's kind of modernized the offense, given it a pro style, you know, kind of blending all the stuff that Lane Kiffin did and Steve Sarkisian did. So, you know, I think he wants that NFL flavor to it. Obviously, Brian Daboll, who's now the Buffalo Bills offensive coordinator, was there for a year. So it's clear that Nick Saban wants to modernize the offense and do kind of professional NFL concepts. And I get that and I respect that. I'm just not sure that Adam Gase is the guy. And let's get into why Adam Gase might not be the guy. First of all, not sure how much you know about him, but he's kind of a weird dude, right? Like he's very aloof. He's bizarre. He makes the faces. And publicly, like, that's not really that big of a thing if you're good behind the scenes. But he wasn't good behind the scenes. He basically got shredded by all his former players. And I don't know that over the last couple years he did a very good job developing players at the NFL level. Sam Darnold did not get better from year one to year three. Now, you can argue there's not enough talent around Sam Darnold, whatever. Look at all the young quarterbacks that are flourishing in the NFL. Joe Burrow, yes, maybe he had a little bit more talent, but Joe Burrow was really good from day one. Justin Herbert, despite being limited in some capacities by the play calling, by the offense in with the LA Chargers, he was really good. Kyler Murray was awesome in the first couple years of his NFL career. Sam Darnold did not get better at all. And some of that does fall on the coaching, and some of it falls on the fact that Adam Gase feels a little bit weird. He's kind of aloof. Like I said, some of the players, Jamal Adams specifically criticized him, said, you know, he's not a leader, he's not a leader of men, all of those things. Which brings me to number two. You come coach in college, you got to go recruit. And you could say what you want about Lane Kiffin, you could say what you want about Steve Sarkisian, whatever. Those guys have been around college football. They're dynamic in the home. They're both great recruiters. Lane Kiffin has his little issues on the side. He's a little immature at times, but the guy knows how to recruit, right? You're going to send Adam Gase into somebody's home and try to have him convince mom and dad why this kid needs to spend the next 4 or 5 years in Tuscaloosa? And I know that Alabama kind of sells itself at this point, but part of it is you still got to send this guy in. You still got to have him leading the home visit, and you still got to have him articulate why he is the guy to put your future in his hands. And maybe it won't matter again because Alabama's so good. But on the flip side, Alabama's now recruiting against the best of the best. And I know Ryan Day knows how to sell Ohio State. And I know Lincoln Riley knows how to sell Oklahoma. And to his credit, I know Nick Saban knows how to sell Alabama. But again, Adam Gase is going to be the one in charge of the offense calling the plays, and I just don't know that he is the guy that you want going into somebody's home and representing your university. I'm sure he's a nice guy, but we're talking about selling, we're talking about recruiting, we're talking about the things that you need to do to win at the highest level in college football. I don't doubt that he can call plays, but is he the guy that is going to sell Alabama in people's homes? And then on top of that, is he the guy that's going to articulate and communicate and build relationships when kids get to campus? Again, Lane Kiffin, Steve Sarkisian, players swear by them. Players die for them. Is Adam Gase going to be that guy? I don't know. Finally, let me just say this too. On top of everything else, I think Adam Gase is kind of overrated. And I know he was a former NFL head coach, but his entire career was basically made off the fact that he had a couple record-setting offenses in Denver about 7 or 8 years ago. Just one problem. You know who Denver's quarterback was at that point? Some guy named Peyton Manning. How much did Adam Gase really do when he was the offensive coordinator with Peyton Manning and the Denver Broncos? I'm guessing not much. I'm guessing Peyton Manning basically called the plays. I'm guessing Peyton Manning basically installed the offense. It's a lot like coaching LeBron James. You coach LeBron James, you're getting to the NBA Finals. You could be, you don't have to be an X's and O's savant. You're getting to the NBA Finals. You have Peyton Manning in his, even if it was the tail end of his prime, that guy's going to score a lot of points for you and look good. Then Adam Gase goes to Chicago as an offensive coordinator, and then he becomes an NFL head coach where he had one winning season to start things and has not won more than 7 games since then. 6-10, 7-9, goes to the Jets, 7-9, 2-14 this season. So are we sure he's really a good coach? Because he was really good with Peyton Manning for a couple years when I could have been the offensive coordinator and been really good with Peyton Manning. And oh, by the way, there's 1 year in Chicago, he revitalized Jay Cutler's career. Bears finished 18th in total offense that year. Stop. They were in the bottom half of the league in offense. Stop. And so when I look at this situation with Nick Saban, again, it just goes back to the most basic level. I trust Saban. He is the GOAT, right? Like, he is the greatest that we have ever seen. He may be the greatest in the history of college football. I just think there's got to be somebody else. I don't know if it's Tom Herman. I don't know if it's whoever. Maybe it's Bill O'Brien. But I just can't see Adam Gase becoming a college offensive coordinator, building relationships with young players, going into homes recruiting, selling Alabama, getting them to campus, working with them, becoming a trusted resource. Like, I just don't see it. So it'll be fascinating to see. I trust Nick Saban. And the one thing I will say about Nick Saban, even with guys that he's worked with and many guys that he hasn't, he does a very good job in the vetting process. He isn't going to bring in somebody unless it's what's best for Alabama. I'm just telling you, it feels really, really, really weird, and I am just not sold that Adam Gase is the guy for this team.